Tonight, the last stop for the monorail. It's being torn down after 25 turbulent years.
It's been an intrusive, ineffective transport system.
Tonight it's been bagged from the moment it was proposed as the expensive and ugly train ride to nowhere. Now the Sydney Monorail is being torn down.
10 State political reporter Josh Murphy is in Pyrmont. Josh, why now?
Well, Bill, first of all, it's simply getting too old. The carriages need replacing and tens of millions of dollars need to be spent to keep it running properly. But not only that, it's hindering development of transport in central Sydney and the renewal of Darling Harbour. So the state government has bitten the bullet and bought out the private company so it can be dismantled. So despite the controversial history of the monorail, many people I spoke to today do believe it is an icon, but even more people I spoke to today say it is an icon.
It's cut a path through central Sydney for almost 25 years. The supports attract graffiti. It's rusting. And now the entire monorail system will be ripped down.
And many argue that its use-by date has arrived, and that's certainly the government's position.
It's bought the private company which operates the monorail and Sydney's light rail for a bargain $20 million. The trams will be expanded, but monorail's headed for the scrapyard.
That is very not helpful, you know.
So it's a form of transport that I do actually use to get into town every now and then.
But not enough have been. Passenger numbers remain in decline. From the very beginning, it attracted major protests and was labelled Monster Rail. This was opening day in 1988 with vocal critic Clover Moore.
The monorail is the most offensive structure to assault our city since the Carl Expressway curtained off Sydney Harbour.
A quarter century on, that opinion holds.
It's been an intrusive, ineffective transport system.
And even today, it gets a reaction.
I think it's pretty revolting when you look along here.
It's a matter of if it was but ugly, but it was purposeful. That'd be cool. But it doesn't actually serve a use.
That's exactly the Premier's opinion.
The real problem with the monorail, I think, for most Sydneysiders is that it doesn't actually go anywhere that you want to go.
I don't actually even know where the stations are, so...
Its removal will also allow for the easier redevelopment of Sydney's new convention centre. Buying the light rail as well means less red tape to expand the tram system.
We don't want to be stuck, in decade-old technology. We need a modern, efficient system in the CBD.